Good morning. Good morning, and thank you for joining us today for the culminating event of our school year. At this time, I would ask that you ensure that your cell phones are turned off. Please stand and demonstrate your national pride by joining us in singing O Canada. Please remain standing as our incoming Student Council President, Devin Shute, comes forward to open our program in prayer.
Morning, everybody. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I'd just like to thank you that we were able to come together today just to celebrate what we've been able to do this past year and the many accomplishments that we've had in this school. I'd like to pray that you'd be with everybody who's talking today and accepting awards. I pray that there would just be a graciousness and a fluidity to what we do today. I pray that you'll be with all of us as it's kind of the end of the school year for all of us. And I pray that you'll just help us to enjoy our summer, help it to be a time for us to regenerate and rejuvenate our energy for the upcoming school year. I pray all of this in Christ's name. Amen.
Please be seated. As you can see, the elementary students are ready to kick off today's program with the song, How Great Is Our God, following which the grades 1 through 4 will perform hot cross buns.
Thank you.
Thank you, elementary students. The 2015-2016 school year brought many changes in our nation, our province, and our school community. At GCS, we introduced new school branding, colors, and a website. Our reputation as the premier provider of English language learning on PEI has caused our school population to swell. Technology is being utilized to a greater degree than ever before at every grade level. Both print and social media have recognized GCS as a leader in STEM education, science, technology, engineering, and math. And recently, GCS was named this year's winner of the Excellence in Education Award from Education 2020. Although we pride ourselves to be an innovative provider of 21st century education, there is one thing that has not and will not change: our commitment to the tenets of our school. Virtutis, fides, scientia, faith, virtue, and knowledge. This year, we have focused on the theme of truth. In a society where truth is often deemed to be relative, and individuals are desperately searching for meaning, something worth living and dying for, we will hold fast to the one who is the truth, Jesus Christ, who is revealed in the handbook of truth, the Bible. 2 Timothy 3:16 tells us that all scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true and to make us realize what is wrong in our lives. It corrects us when we are wrong and teaches us to do what is right. God uses it to prepare and equip his people to do every good work. Not only does the scripture provide guidance and moral training, but it contains the amazing good news of the gospel, salvation through Jesus Christ, who came into the world to save sinners. Through him, we can have a rich, abundant, and meaningful life here on earth, John 10:10, and the promise of an eternal life in heaven, Romans 6:23. The tides of time wash over society, changing the standards of truth in our communities, our media, and our governments. Grace Christian School will choose to cling to the truth, founded on the one who is the same yesterday, today, and forever. One of the foundational truths of GCS is a commitment to service. In Mark 12:30 and 31, Christ teaches that to love God and love people is the greatest of all commandments. One of the ways this is demonstrated is through service to others. As a school community, we are so blessed by our volunteers, without whom many programs could not function. Thank you to our hot lunch organizers, field trip drivers, art elective instructors, sports coaches, elementary classroom helpers, and every other person who serves by sharing their time and talent in the ministry of Grace Christian School. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you also to all our school families for their support of our major fundraising efforts, including the Pancake Breakfast, the Planters Gala, the GCS Family Fun Run, and the golf tournament. Being placed in a province like PEI means that God has entrusted resources to us with which we can bless others. Over the 2015-2016 school year, through student council casual days and other student initiatives, $150 was donated to cancer research following the annual Terry Fox Run. $380 was raised through the World Vision Coin Drive to purchase a variety of medical, educational, and agricultural products for families in the developing world. 176 boxes were packed to be sent on an international mission of love through Samaritan's Purse Operation Christmas Child. Over $250 was given to the Coldest Night Walk Against Homelessness, and $200 was presented to the Easter Seals Ambassador when she visited the school this spring. In addition, due to the support of parents, the participation of students, and the commitment of Mrs. Elsie Barrett and Mrs. Carolyn Thorne to biweekly hot dog sales, $100 per month was contributed to Ms. Beverly Fair and her work at Sahel Academy in Niger. Since December, Prince Edward Island has become the new home for refugee families fleeing war-torn Syria. As a service mission, last January, the grade 3-4 class helped to sort clothing donated for these refugees. In all, the class, plus some other volunteers from our school and the community, helped 11 of the very first families to arrive on our island. The extra clothing was sold by the pound and given to the Welcome Center to assist its volunteers in their work. In February, the elementary students were touched by the story of Callum Thompson, an 8-year-old boy who was diagnosed with APL leukemia. Not only did the students pray for Callum and continue to pray for him, they raised a little more than $700 to help with the family's travel expenses and gave him a huge card filled with encouraging Bible verses and best wishes. Thankfully, Cal is doing quite well and has returned to PEI to continue his treatments. 2015-2016 has been a busy and productive year at Grace Christian School. In addition to academics and community service projects, we had field trips, special guests, after-school learning programs, labs, athletics, music, and drama. We participated in commemorative remembrance activities, embraced Love of Reading Week, got active for Family Fitness Week, and expanded our horizons during Science and Technology Week. Mr. Ellis and Mrs. McNeil have prepared a year in review for your enjoyment.
Thank you.
Grace Christian School aspires to graduate students who are spiritually, academically, emotionally, physically, and socially mature to the glory of God. This morning, we will recognize student achievement in each of these areas, beginning with the Principal's Physical Fitness Award. The Principal's Physical Fitness Challenge recognizes students for their level of fitness in five disciplines: sit-ups completed in 60 seconds, sit and reach for flexibility, shuttle run, continual right angle push-ups, and a 1 kilometer endurance run. Students who improve in any measure receive the Bronze Award. Students who achieve in the 85th percentile in one area and at least the 50th percentile in at least two other areas will receive the Silver Award. Students achieving in the 85th percentile in all but one area receive the Gold Award. Platinum Awards are presented to students who score above the 85th percentile in all five events. All of these certificates have been inserted in the report cards, but we would like to recognize those students who have achieved the highest level. Students, please stand as I call your name and remain standing until all names have been read. And audience, please hold your applause until the end. Platinum Awards have been merited by Brielle Barrett, Ava Becker, Brenly Bissett, Zach Shepard, Darian Small, Riley Bissett, Clara Pocket, Ava Shepard, Paul Wenzhou, Caleb Heron, Simon McGonnell, Lindsay Pollard, Christiane Riverall, Nathan Chong, Alexa Rancourt, Enrique Riverall, Isabella Abel, Sam Bailey, Emily Chong, Danielle LeBlanc, Anna Pocket, Julia Izard, Zoe Good, and Danielle McGonnell. Yeah. 2015-2016 was an exciting year of growth and successes for GCS athletes. Our students participated in 12 sports under 15 coaches, with total team membership of 300 athletes representing our school this year. There were hundreds of volunteer hours, and none of these sports programs could have run without committed volunteers and parents. It is a sacrifice on everyone's behalf. 2 weeks ago, we honored the hard work and dedication of these student athletes in our inaugural Sports Awards ceremony. The coaches recognized most valuable player, most improved player, and player who best exemplified leadership for each team. Today, we would like to celebrate Grace Christian School's 8 provincial champions. Mr. Beach will come to the stage to present commemorative GCS sportswear to each champion. Provincial champion in Bantam Girls Discus, Anna Pocket. Provincial champion in midget women's cross country, 800 meter, 1200 meter, where she bested the previous record by 6.9 seconds, and 2000 meter, Alexa Rancourt. Provincial champion in juvenile women's discus and 300 meters, setting new benchmarks in both events, Zoe Good. The provincial champion in senior A men's golf, Jonah McMillan, was recognized at our graduation ceremony last week. The Laura Mattson Sports Award is awarded to the male and female students in both junior and senior high who best exemplify excellence in athletics, leadership, respect, sportsmanship, consistency, and commitment to the team. The Senior High Male Athlete of the Year was presented at our graduation ceremony. The Senior High Female Athlete of the Year is Zoe Good. The Junior High Male Athlete of the Year is Bryden Dockendorf. The Junior High Female Athlete of the Year is Alexa Rancourt. The Duke of Edinburgh's Award is an exciting self-development program available to all young people ages 14 to 25, equipping them with life skills to make a difference to themselves, their communities, and the world. To date, over 500,000 young people from Canada and 8 million youth in 140 countries have been motivated to undertake a variety of voluntary and challenging activities. Currently, there are over 45,000 Canadians participating in the bronze, silver, or gold level of the program. Grace Christian School has been actively involved in this program for over 15 years, with more than 80 of our students achieving awards at some level. The award program comprises four sections. The service section is intended to develop a sense of community and social responsibility. The adventurous journey section aims to cultivate a spirit of adventure and discovery and an understanding of the environment. The skills section develops cultural, vocational, and practical skills, and the physical recreation section encourages improved performance and fitness. The residential project can be undertaken at any time during participation in the award, but is only submitted at the goal level. There are three award levels, bronze, silver, and gold, each requiring an increasing level of commitment and effort. The bronze usually takes 6 to 12 months to complete, the silver 12 to 18, and the gold 18 to 24 months. Today, we would like to recognize students who over the last school year have achieved levels of this prestigious award. Students, please stand and remain standing when I call your name. Awarded the bronze level, Hannah McGonnell, Alexa Rancourt, Enrique Riverall, and Baden Thompson. Awarded the silver level, Emma Arthurs, Julia Izard, Zoe Good, Larissa Holloway, and Danielle McGonnell. Congratulations. I ask Mr. Neil Thompson, Vice President of the PEI chapter of the Duke of Edinburgh Society, to come to the stage. One of our grade 11 students has completed all requirements for the gold level and is waiting to receive her final award from His Royal Highness, the Prince Edward, Earl of Wessex, or his representative. We would like to recognize this significant achievement for Abby Thompson. And Mr. Thompson, maybe on your way down, you could push that xylophone in just a little bit. No, the next one. Thank you. For over 50 years, the Royal Canadian Legion has sponsored annual poster and literary contests open to all students in the Canadian school system. The youths who participate in these contests assist the Legion in one of their primary goals, fostering the tradition of remembrance amongst Canadians. Vanessa Squires, please stand. Vanessa placed first in the poetry division for the Kingston Legion District and will read her poem at next year's Remembrance Day services. The PEI Newcomers Association held an anti-racism awareness week earlier this year. During this time, high school students across PEI were asked to creatively write stories and poetry that would emphasize the need for anti-racism in our schools and communities. A first place award was presented to Michelle Westerkamp for her short story. Second place was awarded to Rosie McLeod and Rebecca Penny for their poetry. The girls received their awards on April 2nd at the Newcomers Anti-Racism Ceremony. Would Rosie, Michelle, and Rebecca please stand? Earlier this spring, the grade 3-4 class was invited to participate in Stratford's Water School program to learn about water conservation and wetlands. As part of the day, the students created drawings containing information that they had learned. Would Mr. Beach and Jaden Summers please come to the stage? Jaden's drawing was chosen to be featured in a calendar which will be distributed to the residents of Stratford and used in schools across PEI. Over the last few years, we have welcomed a number of new international students to GCS. These students vary in age, grade level, and English foundation. Some have come to PEI with family. Others have spent the year with island host families. Moving from one's native country and familiar culture is very difficult. Learning a new language, complete with its unique structure, grammar, and idioms, is even more challenging. Dr. Suzanne Heising will now come to the stage to recognize ESL students who, through diligence and tenacity in the ESL program, have achieved significant improvement in both oral and written communication. The award for the most improved elementary level 1 or 2 English language learner is presented to Brock Jin. He's not with us today. The award for the most improved elementary level 3 or 4 English language learner is presented to David Dew. The award for the most improved junior or senior high level 1 or 2 English language learner is presented to Lucy Gong. The award for the most improved junior or senior high level 3 or 4 English language learner is presented to Damika Ziao. Congratulations, students. At this time, the grade 5 and 6 class are going to come to the stage to prepare for their performance, Orange Juice. Thank you. We will now recognize the students who have attained the honor rolls. A honor roll is achieved by earning an average of 90% or above. B honor roll, an average between 80 and 90%. We will begin with high school. These students have merited the honor roll. Students, as I call your name, please stand and remain standing until all recipients in your class have been recognized. I ask that you hold your applause until the end of each group. Grade 11, A honor roll, Rachel Hamilton, Devin Shute, and Olivia Zhou. Grade 11, B honor roll, Alina Chu, Oye Otisajo, Abby Thompson, Michelle Westerkamp, and Eason Zhang. Grade 10, A honor roll, Emma Arthurs, Christia Deng, Julia Izard, Zoe Good, and Danielle McGonnell. Grade 10, B honor roll, Rogan Ni and Demika Zhao. Grade 9, A honor roll, Nathan Chong, Bailey Heising, Hannah McGonnell, Enrique Riveral, and Yubri Zhu. Grade 9, B honor roll, Baden Thompson. Grade 8, A honor roll, Sam Bailey, Susanna Hamilton, Danielle LeBlanc, Kenzie Manalili, Angelina Ning, and Ade Otisaja. Grade 8, B honor roll, Kate Adams, Nancy Fan, Jack Han, Minnie Jen, and Peter Yang. Grade 7, A honor roll, Isabella Abel, Emily Chong, Anna Pocket, Mitchell Shute, and Luke Thompson. Grade 7, B honor roll, Esther Eastwood, Michaela Holloway, Leo Jing, and Alexandria Nowlin. Elementary, A and B honor roll. Again, students, as I call your name, please stand and remain standing until all recipients in your class have been recognized. And once again, I thank you that you hold your applause until the end of each group. Grade 6, A honor roll. Tony Tang, Taylor Stackhouse, Christiane Riveral, Brianna Rancourt, Tennyson Arsenault, Penelope Abel, and David Dew. Grade 6, B honor roll, Joshua Perry, Evelyn McCarville, and James Dockendorf. Grade 5, A honor roll, Ashley Chong, Li Deng, Caleb Heron, Simon McGonnell, Jasmine Yu, and Ronnie Wei. Grade 5, B honor roll, Lindsay Pollard, Titus Eastwood, T.Y. Shum, Richard Sun, Zihan Lee. Grade 4, A honor roll, Carly LeBlanc, Joshua Nowlin, Clara Pocket, William Vandenberg, and Paulin Zhao. Grade 4, B honor roll, Cecily Abel and Kyler Barrett. Grade 3, A honor roll, Riley Bissett, Eva McNeil, Ava Shepherd, Jaden Summers, and Charlie Wang. Grade 3 B Honor Roll, Cody Rancourt and William Wang. Grade 2 A Honor Roll, Brielle Barrett, Ava Becker, Terrence Chen, Daniel Dan, Sarah Ding, Jasmine Han, Hannah Hood, Belle Q, and Chris Vandenberg. Grade 2 B Honor Roll, Dublin Abel, Micah Bailey, Jude Heron, Brianna Shaw, Darian Small, and Jaden Squires. Grade 1 A Honor Roll, Brenly Bissett, Katie Campbell, Lotus Chan, Elias Eastwood, Lauren McNeil, Leah McNeil, Danny Marie Robbins, and Anson Zhu. Grade 1 B Honor Roll, Elliot Abel, Ethan Becker, Brock Jin, and Morea Summers. Congratulations to all recipients of the Honor Roll. Your achievement is a testament to your hard work. Mr. Beach, please return to the stage. This past spring, 8 students represented Grace Christian School at the Provincial Heritage Fair. In addition to significant media recognition for their projects, a number of students were honored with specialty awards. Isabella Abel, please come to the stage. Isabella's project, Something to Stew About, received awards from the Benevolent Irish Society, the PEI Home Economics Society, and the PEI Social Studies Teachers Association. Christiane Riverall, please come to the stage. Christiane's project, titled More Than a Number, placed in the top 12 at the provincial level. She has also been asked to compete for a spot to represent Prince Edward Island at the national level this fall in Ottawa. In addition, Christiane received the PEI Teachers Federation Award. Hannah McGonnell, please come to the stage. Hannah's project, titled Shining Light on the Past, the Abuse in Residential Schools, merited the top award at the provincial level, the Canada's History Award. She has also been asked to compete for a spot to represent Prince Edward Island at the national level this fall in Ottawa. In addition, Hannah also received the PEI Council of the Arts Award. And I'm sure you've seen the announcements sent out by Mrs. McNeil. Both Christiane and Hannah need your votes to make it to the Nationals. And the information for that is available on our Facebook page. It's just a go online and click, and the girls would really appreciate your support. Angelina Ning and Minnie Jin are not with us to receive their award, but these girls were honored with the Parks Canada Award for their project titled Norman Bethune, the Hero of China. In partnership with a team of committed staff, parents, and other volunteers, GCS students are encouraged to explore their areas of interest. Through a diverse offering of classes, extracurricular clubs, organizations, and service opportunities, students often discover their talents and develop new skills. The elementary staff have collaboratively chosen to recognize a number of students who are passionate about using their giftedness for the glory of God. Mr. Beach will come to the stage to present the Science and Innovation Award, which is presented to students who are driven by their sense of wonderment to ask questions, seek answers, define problems, and discover solutions that are firmly rooted in biblical truth, while applying the concepts of science, technology, engineering, and math. They embrace every opportunity to enrich their learning using a variety of technological tools or resources, and are not afraid to think outside the box to introduce a new idea, method, or innovative solution. This award is presented to Riley Bissett. And Sarah Ding. The Art and Music Award is presented to passionate artists and/or musicians who strive for excellence in their craft. These students are eager to express their creativity and share their talents with others. Their passion for music and/or art shines through them. This award is presented to Tony Tang. And Clara Pocket. The Athletic Award is presented to students who display Christ-like character in the field of athletics. Throughout their participation in a variety of sports, they have learned life lessons and developed qualities which help them reach their potential as future leaders. These students strive for excellence and display sportsmanship as they compete. This award is presented to James Dockendorf. And Penelope Abel. The Fruit of the Spirit Award is presented to students who exhibit the attributes of a Christian life and continually seek to grow in their understanding of truth. They are loving in their interactions with each other, joyful regardless of the situation, peace-seeking, patient, and kind. They are good, faithful, gentle, and display a great sense of self-control. This award is presented to Simon McGonnell. And Christiane Riverall. Congratulations, students. The Elementary Percussion Ensemble will now assemble on stage to perform a march. Mr. Thompson will now come to the stage to present the next high school awards. The Carrie Sawatsky Fine Arts Award, awarded annually to junior and senior high school students who best develop and demonstrate God-given talents in the areas of drama, music, or art. The senior award was presented at our graduation ceremony. The junior high award is presented to Yubri Zhu. Thompson Social Studies Award, awarded annually to the junior and senior high school students who demonstrate keen interest in the social sciences. The senior award is presented to a student who couldn't be with us today, Rachel Hamilton. The junior high award is presented to Hannah McGonnell. Mr. Beach will return to the stage to present the Dave Wessel Science Award, awarded annually to junior and senior high school students who show interest and ability in the sciences at Grace Christian School. The senior award was presented at our graduation ceremony. The junior high award is presented to Nathan Chong. Jonathan Award is presented to junior and senior high students whose love for others has been evidenced by genuine friendliness. The junior high award is presented to Bailey Heising. Senior High Award is presented to a student who could not be with us today, Eason Zhang. The the Paul Award is presented to junior and senior high students who show balance in emotions through demonstration of self-discipline. The Junior High Award is presented to Ade Otisaja. The Senior High Award is presented to Julia Izard. The Timothy Award is presented to junior and senior high students who have demonstrated godliness in character at school. And for the first time in my memory, these awards will be shared. The Junior High Award is shared by Hannah McGonnell. And Hugh Breju. The Senior High Award is shared by Abigail Thompson. And Devin Sheet. Last Friday, the grads were told they couldn't have phones on the stage. This concludes the awards portion of the morning. Dr. Suzanne Heising, please come to the stage.
What a great year. I look at how blessed we are this year, and I stand in awe of God working every single day. I want to thank you as parents, I want to thank you as students, and I want to thank the staff. And again, for the incredible blessing of being part of Grace Christian School. The reason I'm here is because we, the grade 11 class, in our creative writing class, work very hard in creating, writing, producing, and completing a yearbook in 8 weeks. It is super hard work, and the people standing in front of you are our editors, our senior editors, our layout editors, and we would just like to take a moment to tell you who we dedicated the yearbook to. Dear Kevin and Carolyn Thorne, for over 25 years, you have both given countless hours of your time to Grace Christian School. You have both sacrificed so much time and energy into not only GCS, but also into the lives of students and teachers that are part of this community. We appreciate you two so much, but we don't always get a chance to tell you how grateful we are. And so this year, we are very pleased to dedicate our yearbook, our efforts, to Carolyn and Kevin Thorne. Carolyn, can you come up, please? And Kevin's here too, yay, come on. We can't thank you enough for all of your hard work and for most of all, just showing us very unselfishly the heart of service and your heart for God. And I just want to point out Rebecca Penny. Rebecca, can you raise your hand? Rebecca, many, many hours after school, early mornings, late night emails, and editing and editing. And Oye, raise your hand as well. Oye laid out everything. And when we had a crisis at Staples, I would call, I would cry, and here he was. And so we would not be able to produce this yearbook without him. This is his second year helping us out with that. So I just want to point them out.
Invite 2016-2017 Student Council President Devin Shute to introduce his executive council and share a few words.
So apparently I wasn't invited to the yearbook party. It's fine. I did help, but anyways. About 2 years ago now, my family started this tradition where every morning before we leave for school, after we fight over who gets front seat, my mom will turn to the person in the passenger seat and ask them to pray for our day. And she'll have them pray over just if we have any tests or quizzes, if we're stressed about anything, just anything that's going to happen in that day. And that's kind of taught me personally the power of prayer, and that's something that I really want to implement next year as we're kind of rolling in. Because I didn't have a campaign, I was the only person who signed up for president. Yeah, I know, scary thought. I didn't get a chance to kind of say everything I want to do next year, and I'll keep the surprise, but kind of what I want to do is I want to implement just the idea of the power that prayer can have. And I want to start that with this summer. So I've got two things that I want, and I want all of you to be involved in this. So first, I really want all of you to pray for me. Students, teachers, parents, grandparents. I want you to pray for me. I want you to pray for my executive, who I'm going to introduce here in a minute. I want you to pray for all of the students, all of the class reps. I want you to just pray for all of us, that we would just be able to, next year, just have a great school year. I'm losing my notes. That we would just have a great school year and have a lot of fun and just make God the center of our school year. Second, I haven't told anybody about this yet, but, yeah, I know, she's scared. I probably won't make it happen. Probably. Anyways. I want to, later in the summer, I don't have a date yet because I don't think that far ahead. I want to have a chance for a group of us just to gather here and pray over the school and pray over this building. In my mind, I have a dream of us being able to make a giant circle around the school. And whether we're here for 30 seconds or 3 hours, I just want us to be able to stand there and just pray over the school and pray over the building for our school year, because I believe that there is a power not only in praying for a place, but actually being in a place when you pray for it. So I'll figure something out in making sure the word gets out on that when we're planning on having it. But I definitely want to, at least myself and my executive, sorry guys, my executive, just come here and be able to pray over this building for the next school year. So I've brought them up a couple times, so I guess it's good time for me to introduce my executive. Two of them aren't here today, but guys, whenever I call your name, can you just stand up and give everyone a little wave? So for my secretary for next year, I have Rachel Hamilton. She's not able to be here with us today. For treasurer, because I'm not very good with money, I have Zoe Good. Zoe, can you stand up? To coordinate intramurals, because I have no understanding of sports, I have Julia. And as my vice president, I have Rogan. All right, just give that one more round of applause as a group. So I'm really excited to have this executive, and I'm really looking forward to next year. I think we're going to have a lot of fun. I think they'll be able to balance out my kind of haphazard way of life. So just feel free to pray for us if we ever cross your mind this summer or throughout the next school year. Just pray for us, because my goal is that we're able to make God the center of our next school.
This year, two of our staff members have reached milestones in consecutive years of service at Grace Christian School. Mr. Jordan Ellis graduated from GCS in 1999, but always maintained a connection with the school. In 2006, he joined the staff full-time, providing much-needed technical support and know-how. In addition to that role, Mr. Ellis shares his expertise in software application programming, web design, calculus, and physics with his students. This year marks not only 10 years of consecutive service to Grace Christian School, but also the beginning of a new role for Mr. Ellis, school parent, when his son Andrew began junior kindergarten last September. Staff are always asked what they would like to receive as a gift with their recognition. And with a decision that is quintessentially Mr. Ellis, he asked for meat. Thank you, Mr. Ellis, for all you do for us, students and staff. Mr. Jordan Ellis. There's more than just that one piece. Mrs. Ann Laird. Mrs. Laird joined the teaching staff of GCS when the school was in its infancy and she wasn't much older. She met and married her husband Lee, and as time progressed, they were blessed with a daughter, a son, and another daughter. After taking time off to raise their children, Mrs. Laird returned to teach at Grace Christian School, and for the last 20 years has blessed the students and staff with her passion, her dedication, and her generous spirit. For morning high fives, encouragement to keep running, motivation to go home, and many, many other things, thank you, Mrs. Laird. Mrs. Ann Laird. This year's Planters Gala, the theme was the GCS of yesterday, today, and tomorrow. As we reflect on how far we have come and where we are now, we are confident that God will continue to lead us in the paths He has for our future as well. As more and more families see the benefit of Christ-centered education from both ideological and academic perspectives and choose to enroll their children here, our physical limitations are increasingly apparent. Mr. Beach.
Thank you, Mrs. Thompson. Again, I want to say on behalf of Grace Christian School to our parents, to grandparents, to friends, thank you for being a part of our school. Thank you for your commitment. For some of you who have older students, you've been here for a number of years, and we appreciate your investment that you're making and continue to make in our school. This has been an incredible year. This is last year, as I stood before you, we unveiled our new brand, and our brand has swept through our school student body. It has swept through our community. It has even made notice in different places when we go to athletic events. And it's exciting to see how it's brought a lot of school spirit. And we continue to look at ways to bring more school spirit. I know that Devin and his personality is going to do that with his executive. And that is the type of students we have here. We have students who have all ranges of gifts and giftedness. And today we saw that again. And I'm so blessed to be able to be a part of Grace Christian School and to be given the opportunity to be the leader of this school. But we are looking at things in our school that we are seeing such abundance of. And I want to just share a few things today. First off, spiritual formation. As you've seen even witnessed today, a lot of our students are having and are being given a deep foundation in Christ. And let's remember that that is why we exist as Grace Christian School. As Mrs. Thompson said at the beginning, we hold to the truth, and that's God's truth. In a society that is all about relativism and all about relative truth, Grace Christian School will continue to stand for God's truth, because that is the only real truth that's out there. As far as academics are concerned, a witness today to just the strong academics that we provide in our school, the quality of academics that we provide in our school. And for some of you that weren't able to come to either our gala or to our graduation last week, you should have seen the amount of awards given to the students. It was mind-blowing. Just alone, these are the universities that our students in grade 12 have been accepted to. We've had 5 students accepted to McGill University, to University of Toronto, to University of UBC, to Waterloo University, to Guelph University, to UPI, to Holland College. That is the quality. These students are getting into whatever program they want, and that will continue to happen at our school. The little ones who are getting the foundation, when they get to grade 12, will have no problem going where they want to go and doing what they want to do. That's the quality of academics in our school. The arts, we are witness today to the arts, to the arts of drawing and writing, to seeing them play music, to drama, if you were able to be a part of when our drama club came up and did drama presentation. It was incredible. To science innovation, this is we are leading the charge, not only in PEI with science innovation, but we're also leading the charge in ACSI in Eastern Canada as well. Myself and Mr. Ellis were up past November speaking at the ACSI conference. Multiple times I'm being called and consulted on how to bring more technology and innovation into school. And to be given an award from the 2020 education is a big, big monument for our school. So I'm very excited where we're going. And we're going to continue to go in that area. And athletics, we have, I think, a lot with our new school brand and the school spirit. We have a recharge of athletics. But I want to say this about our athletics program. As successful as it was this year, it's only successful because of the parents who volunteered the time to be the coaches. That's a testimony. A lot of the programs that we have would not happen and would not be successful unless parents came and said, we want to do this for the school. So thank you on behalf of the staff for that. And how can you get over the fact that we had 12 sports, 300 participants in those sports, and 8 provincial titles just from our school? That is monumental. That is incredible. And that is continually going to grow in the future. And so on top of that, as you walked in today, you see the look in this place is very different. And in January of 2017, we will be opening an early child care center just in the back part that will have the foyer plus an early child care center. That will eventually bring more and more students to our school. And so with all that happening, And with, on top of that, the global education and the program that we have under the direction of Dr. Heising that has astronomical numbers that are coming into our program. And we're seeing it not just from Asia, we're seeing it from other countries as well, that they want to send their children to our school. We do not have the facilities to handle what this school needs for the future in all the areas I just discussed. And so one of the things that we did at our gala is we presented and launched our capital campaign. And what I'd like to do today, and I thought, what a better way to end today than to show you where we're going in the future. And I thought, what a better way for our students to actually hear and see, this is where we want to go. And so I'm going to get Mr. Ellis to show our capital campaign video and understand, this is where we're going in the future.
Seeds were sown over 35 years ago when some faithful men and women believed in the ideals of educating their children in a Christ-centered environment. Ground was broken, a school was planted, and roots were established, roots of faith, virtue, and knowledge. A lot has changed since our first classes in 1980. Our students now receive a dynamic 21st century liberal arts education from junior kindergarten through grade 12, because those who came before them saw the need to plant for the future, and they gave generously.
We have come so far in the first 35 years, but our desire is to prepare for the next 35 years and beyond. We cannot do education like it was done years ago. That is why it's time to plant a seed.
Grace Christian School has a clear vision for the future, one that will expand our facilities to accommodate the needs of today's learners and provide them with modern spaces to collaborate and innovate. The school is embarking on an ambitious $3.5 million campaign to enhance the learning and school environment in four key areas: global education, the arts, science and innovation, and athletics. Only with your help and generosity can we fully attain this goal within the next few years.
The families before us created the GCS of yesterday. We feel it is our responsibility to create the GCS of tomorrow. That means designing learning environments in which students are actively engaged in inquiry work, where students read, question, analyze, create, and problem solve at all age levels. That's the GCS of tomorrow.
New infrastructure will be constructed to house our growing international studies program, fabrication lab, art studio, performing arts program, library resource center, and our athletic department. This plan includes opportunities for students to experience God's creation firsthand, as well as the space required for students to innovate and express their creativity. The Global Innovation Center will be home to a digital fabrication lab that will put cutting-edge technology for design and construction into the hands of every student at GCS, and will provide a dedicated space for invention, creation, discovery, and sharing. Several modern learning environments will also be designed to engage all learners. They will provide the much-needed space for students in our growing international studies program to learn a new language and fully understand what it means to be an active global citizen in North America. A modern library resource center will offer an array of literature and provide space for students to enrich their love of reading, while a new creative art studio will encourage artistic expression among all learners at GCS. The Global Innovation Center will also be home to a new large open learning space that will allow students the flexibility to move around and work collaboratively in small groups. The possibilities with this space are endless and easily accommodate the needs of 21st century learners. A fully equipped science lab, technology and innovation hub, and cafe will also expand the possibilities for the GCS of tomorrow.
Now is the time to irrigate. It's time to water the seeds as they grow into leaders, thinkers, and innovators of tomorrow.
At GCS, our mission is to equip children to become spiritually, academically, emotionally, physically, and socially mature. Our athletics program is vital to this mission. We have several athletic teams in a variety of sports, which puts a tremendous strain on our current facility. A new multi-sport athletic center will provide a full-sized home gymnasium for our athletes, as well as locker rooms and ample storage space for sports equipment. A fitness training center will provide students with more modern athletic facilities to maintain an active, healthy lifestyle. The athletic center will also be home to our performing arts department and will allow us to expand our current programs. A large band and choir room, a recording studio, and practice rooms will foster and develop the artistic talents of both young and old within our school community.
Our leaders, thinkers, and innovators of tomorrow need the nourishment that these new facilities will provide. It is up to us to ensure that these seeds grow.
When the men and women who founded GCS hired the first teachers, when the first classes were taught in the church overflows, when tests were handwritten, who would have envisioned the GCS of today? Only the one who knows the end from the beginning. God has blessed the ministry of Grace Christian School and continues to move in the hearts of individuals who value kingdom education. Give today as our vision for tomorrow becomes a reality. Join us in planting a seed and growing a future.
This is the future of Grace Christian School. Is it ambitious? Yes, but we serve a great God. We serve a God who will supply. Can we do this alone? No, but if we come together as a group and we come together as families, as a school, as a community, there's no doubt that this is going to take place. And so as we go off and as we celebrate today, the GCS of today, as we reflected on the GCS of the past, let's think about where we're going and the plans for the GCS of tomorrow. These are exciting times to be a part of Grace Christian School. And I look forward to the future. I look forward to being a part of this. I trust you look forward to being a part of this. And I know as students, they'll definitely look forward to being a part of what's going to happen in the future. So let's come together, let's work together, and let's make this happen. Let's pray. God, thank you for Grace Christian School. Thank you for those who have come before us to make what we have today and to allow us to be able to celebrate the gifts and the talents and the successes of today. But let us also remember, Lord, as you are blessing, that it's up to us to look to the future. And so may we come together as a school. May we look at ways in which we can come up with funds to make this happen together. Lord, may you continue to shine your grace on our school. May you continue to work in the hearts of young people in our school, from young, those that are just entering, to those that are graduating. Lord, may we continue to always hold fast to your truth and always remember that no matter what, we are to follow your word. Lord, I thank you for the staff that give in, day out to the lives and invest in the lives of the young people that come here. And I thank you for the parents, Lord. May you continue to be in their lives. May you continue to guide them and direct them as they raise their children. And so as we enter a summer, Lord, protect us, watch over us, and bring us all back safely in the fall. We pray this in your name. Amen. And now, you guys have done so well, the young ones sitting and being patient, and now it's time to get your report card. So you'll go down to your classroom, and you can get your report card, and then we will see you all back after you have a tremendous summer on September the 6th. Thank you very much. Have a great summer, guys.